Who would win in a fight between a tiger and an elephant? What about a wolf versus a puma? An alligator versus a python? Well, I have news. These ultimate animal showdowns are not just hypothetical. These are things that actually happen in the wild, and the animal that comes out on top might surprise you. After all, we are taught in school that nobody beats an apex predator. They're at the top of the food chain. But when two of them come head to head, sometimes even an apex predator becomes prey. So let's look at what the research says about these clashes of titans, and you can see how many of the champions you can guess. So in India, there are about 3,000 Bengal tigers and 30,000 elephants. And the elephants not only outnumber the tigers, they are also a lot bigger. Indian elephants weigh up to 6,000 kilograms, while tigers typically top out at a mere 230. So you might think that the pachyderms have this fight in the bag. But they are also vegetarians. Herbivorous elephants don't want to fight tigers. I mean, we've never asked them about it, but they usually make themselves scarce when they hear a tiger approach. Same, elephants. I also do that. See, tigers might be smaller than full-grown elephants, but not elephant babies. And if you're a tiger, a baby elephant probably sounds like a nice little snack. Actually, like a nice several meals. So to complement their diet of deer and antelope, tigers eat elephants too. They won't usually pick a fight with a herd, but they have been known to pick off an elephant calf. So round one goes to tigers. But that victory may be short-lived. Literally. Now, there aren't a ton of peer-reviewed publications about elephants killing tigers, but in 2021, a tiger was found dead where a herd of elephants had been the previous day. A post-mortem of the tiger suggested that it had been stomped to death. I'll spare you the gory details here, but suffice to say that elephants can end a tiger. Which means that this first showdown will have a different winner depending on the circumstances. And since picking on babies is a low move, even for tigers, I'm gonna give this one to elephants. Either way, pick on someone your own size doesn't really apply to this matchup, but the next one comes closer. If you spend enough time boating around the coast of South Africa, you might see orcas and great white sharks, but I cannot promise you that you will like what you see. As formidable as great white sharks are, orcas are the real apex predator in pretty much all of their observed interactions. Orcas will hunt white sharks in pods or one-to-one. Basically, they are always ready to pick a fight. And they don't just start the fight, they end it. In 2022, 5 orcas were filmed surrounding a white shark. One of the orcas got underneath the shark and pushed it up to the ocean surface. Then, the orca rolled the shark over and bit into it. The altercation ended with orcas feasting on the shark's liver. That's one point for orcas. The following year, scientists observed another face-off, but this time, it looked like it would be more evenly matched. One orca went up against one shark, and the orca eviscerated the shark. And that is the actual exact word that they used in the journal article that was published in the African Journal of Marine Science. It all happened in under 2 minutes. The orca grabbed the shark by its pectoral fin and charged forward. Then the orca, you guessed it, ate its liver. As it turns out, a white shark's liver has many of the nutrients an orca needs to be healthy, as well as the convenient fact that livers float. So at least the orcas are getting a solid meal out of the deal. Yay. So that puts the score at orcas 2, sharks 0. Just another reason to stop calling them great white sharks. They aren't even apex predators when an orca's around. Not to mention, they are the only white sharks. But they are not the only marine animals on this list of showdowns. Tuna and jellyfish both live in the Mediterranean Sea. It's a great place to make babies. Who can blame them? But as relaxing and romantic as that sounds, things can get tense. Researchers have analyzed the stomachs of bluefin tuna and found that more than half of their diet is gelatinous animals like jellyfish. Depending on how big the tuna is and how much energy it needs to swim around, the number of jellyfish casualties could go up. So tuna are definitively formidable predators when it comes to jellyfish. They're the kind of predators that you wouldn't expect to have any trouble swimming through jellyfish swarms and picking them off for snacks throughout the day. Bluefin tuna are some of the fastest fish in the world, reaching 70 kilometers per hour when they really go for it. But just like elephants, tuna can switch from predator to prey fast, depending on how old they are, baby tuna take a while to develop their tail fins, making them vulnerable to hungry jellyfish. And yes, the jellyfish take advantage of this weakness and eat them. So this one might seem like kind of a toss-up, but we can't quite call it yet because there's one more round to go. See, tuna protect their babies by avoiding dangerous jellyfish when they breed. By spawning where there are fewer jellyfish, tuna have a better chance of surviving past youth. The only problem is that there's a reason jellyfish don't hang out in that part of the Mediterranean. There's less food there. Tuna might successfully avoid becoming prey to the animals that they eat, but it comes at the risk of their own starvation. With so little food around, some tuna resort to cannibalism. So in the battle between jellyfish and tuna, the tuna start taking themselves out and do the jellyfish's work for them. Ultimately, when they steer clear of jellyfish, 90% of the baby tuna survive and 70% make it through their fin development stage. So the trade-off is probably worth it. But it puts this battle at a draw. Not all animal showdowns have a winner as clear as in the next battle, but before we get to that next fight, a quick ad.
Thanks to ACT for supporting this SciShow video. ACT is the number one taken college admissions test in nearly half of US states based on 2024 grad class data, and it's accepted by all colleges. But even with those accolades, enhancements are coming to the ACT to streamline the student testing experience. The enhanced ACT gives you the shortest test time yet, with 44 fewer questions, which means more time per question so you can stress less, plus the choice of whether or not to take the science section. And they let you try real ACT science questions before you take the test at quizme.act.org. The whole idea is to give you flexibility to test your best. And if that means testing online or on paper, you have that choice too. You can learn more about the ACT or register for the next upcoming test at act.org/scishow by scanning the QR code or by clicking the link in the description.
It is the ultimate showdown between dog and cat in this corner. Standing 76 centimeters tall and weighing 45 kilograms, it's the gray wolf. And in this corner, standing 65 centimeters tall and weighing 75 kilograms, the mighty puma. People put these two in the same ring in 1995, knowing pretty well who was going to come out on top. We introduced gray wolves to Yellowstone National Park in the US with the intention of keeping the mountain lion population in check. And they might be doing too good of a job. In just 15 years, the puma population there dropped by almost half. Now, the wolves aren't the only ones hunting pumas. Humans do that too. But they've really turned the pumas into what researchers call a subordinate apex predator. Which sounds like an oxymoron based on what you might have learned in school. If an apex predator is at the top of the food chain, they can't be subordinate unless they don't stand a chance against another apex predator, and that's what's happening here. Gray wolves have devastated pumas in a few ways. First, they're clearing out all of the puma's food. Sometimes they scare away prey like elk, and sometimes they just eat the prey that the pumas took down. Classic cafeteria bully behavior. The wolves' other approach is more traditional. Wolves also outright kill pumas. Ultimately, about the same number of pumas starve to death as are killed by wolves. So the more wolves there are roaming around, the fewer pumas survive. Which means the winner is definitely the wolf. It just goes to show you that apex predators aren't always top dogs, and not just because they're cats. Reptiles can have the same problems. So in the Florida Everglades, alligators were living large. Literally, alligators there can weigh more than 450 kilograms, as much as a grand piano. And these apex predators have all the qualities that a peak performing athlete would want. Speed, agility, knowledge of all the best spots for sunbathing. They were so large and in charge that they had an international sports drink named after them. It was actually named after the mascot of the University of Florida, which is named after the Florida apex predator. But with some of the most, let's say, eccentric people in the world living in Florida, circumstances were bound to change. See, some Floridians, this will not surprise you, have dangerous and exotic pets. And from time to time, they lose track of those animals. What I'm trying to say is, there are a lot of escaped pythons in the Everglades. Oops, Who would have thought? The pythons, native to Southeast Asia, have become invasive in Florida to the point that the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service has started calling them an injurious species. So that's not good for the alligators that already lived there, especially because these pythons are some of the largest snakes in the world. They can grow to be 6 meters long and weigh more than 90 kilos. Don't get me wrong, the mighty alligator can handle an intruder. The U.S. Geological Survey has reported alligators eating pythons. Even cyclists biking around Florida have stumbled upon alligators mid-munch on pythons. But pythons also eat alligators. Researchers poking around the stomach contents of snakes have found evidence of alligators in there. At the end of the day, these two top-level reptiles have both been found eating each other. Sometimes they'll end up in a day-long fight that nobody wins. One fight that both alligator and snake managed to slither away from involved an alligator 4.5 meters long and a python that measured 2.7 meters. But they can both die as one tries to eat the other, too. So in this reptilian rumble, there's kind of no winner. They both lose. However, since it is our fault that they know each other at all, humans are working to set things straight. Researchers are helping the alligators retain their dominance by introducing more pythons, but this time they have trackers on them. The tracked pythons find other pythons in the wild, leading researchers right to them so they can remove the serpents from the alligator's stomping grounds. Just the kind of backstabbing behavior you would expect from a snake. So there's not always a clear winner when two of the world's deadliest animals come across each other, and clearly, the whole idea of an apex predator is relative. Even the most cold-blooded killers can be dethroned. But as far as I am concerned, all of them can have the title. I just don't want to go up against any of these guys myself.